So, good morning, dear guests, good morning, dear participants, and thank you for attending our event that is being streamlined on different channels. And we have a kind request that you turn on your video camera so that we can see each other and have an interactive event. Today, the United Nations in Moldova and Moldcel will sign the first of its kind memorandum of
understanding
to strengthen the cooperation for the achievement of sustainable development. The 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, adopted by all United Nations member states in 2015, provides a shared blueprint for peace and prosperity for people and the planet, now and into the future. At its heart are the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, which are an urgent call for action by all countries developed and developing in a global partnership. They recognize that ending poverty and other deprivations must go hand in hand with strategies that improve health and education, reduce inequality, and spur economic growth, all while tackling climate changes and working to preserve our biodiversity. The Republic of Moldova joined the United Nations in 1992.
Since then, the United Nations system supports the country in achieving its major development goals
and fulfilling its vision to be a prosperous and modern European country. Today, 23 resident and non-resident UN specialized agencies, funds and programs are part of the UN country team in Moldova. And I would like now to welcome Mr. Simon Springett, the resident coordinator of the United Nations in Moldova, and invite him to say a few words about the SDGs, UN in Moldova, and today's event. Please, Mr. Springett.
Good morning, and
thank you very, very much for joining us today.
Mulțumesc.
I'm very excited about this first ever memorandum of understanding between the United Nations and a private sector company, Moldcel, in the Republic of Moldova. With this MOU, we look forward to strong cooperation and collaboration on our joint commitment in supporting the achievement of the Sustainable Development Goals in Moldova. The Sustainable Development Goals are our shared blueprint to achieve a better and more sustainable future for all. They address the global challenges that every country faces, including poverty, inequality, climate change, environmental degradation, and peace and justice. In 2020, the government of Moldova presented the country's first voluntary national review, which is a review against the progress of the Sustainable Development Goals. This report was submitted to the High-Level Political Forum on Sustainable Development. And according to the report, Moldova has made noteworthy progress since its commitment to implement the 2030 Agenda. However, there remains more to do. The United Nations in Moldova is a key partner in supporting Moldova's Sustainable Development Goals nationalization and implementation process. However, the attainment of the goals can only be achieved if we work together, government, the private sector, communities, and individuals. Each and every one of us has a key role to play. This is even more important in the context of the COVID-19 crisis. The COVID-19 pandemic has exposed systemic weaknesses and has touched every aspect of our social and economic lives, deepening further the inequalities faced by many already. The memorandum we are going to sign today between Moldcel and the United Nations is the first of its kind to be signed in Moldova. This creates a platform for additional partnerships between the Moldcel Foundation and UN agencies, funds, and programs to further explore the possibilities of developing activities or projects that support Moldova's sustainable development. I'm also very pleased to note that the first cooperation agreement within this framework of the memorandum will also be signed today between the UNFPA and the Moldcel Foundation. I welcome this partnership with Moldcel, now more than ever, as we build back better from the COVID-19 pandemic. The private sector can be a catalyst to move beyond business as usual and to ensure that all business operations support sustainable practices which support people, planet, and our collective prosperity. On behalf of the United Nations system in Moldova, I want to thank you for partnering with the United Nations and to emphasize our gratitude to Moldcel and the Moldcel Foundation, but equally to its parent company, the Chowdhury Group, for your commitment in investing and promoting the SDG agenda. investing in the SDGs and aligning business practices to SDG principles is good for business and it's good for the planet. Through making this event public, we also want to spread the word and to encourage and invite everyone to follow this example, be it companies from the private sector, academia, or elsewhere. We, as the United Nations, would be more than happy to partner for the SDGs and stand by, and we stand ready to share our resources, our tools, and our experiences for this important work. Finally, thank you again to MoldCell and to the MoldCell Foundation. The United Nations country team very much looks forward to our future collaborations. Thank you very much.
Having a video on SDGs. Taking up on your words about the Chowdhury Group, there must be added that due to the perseverance of its managing director, Mr. Nirvana Chowdhury, the UN Moldova MoldCell partnership today is being brought to life. No doubt, the experience of the Chowdhury Group and its foundations in improving the lives of people and strengthening their communities by creating socially responsible businesses will bring added value to this cooperation. I would like now to invite Mr. Nirvana Chowdhury, Managing Director of the Chowdhury Group and President of the MoldCell Foundation, to deliver his statement. Please, you're welcome.
Thank you so much, Ms. Pringit, our partners, my dearest colleagues of MoldCell, a company that we really value and treasure, a company that we are really proud of, who has in the past and is committed to making a difference in the future in Moldova to the lives of the people. CG Corp Global is a company today with a workforce of over 16,000 people present in over 32 countries. We have 15 different diversified verticals. We have today our motto that says touching life every day, because pretty much every product that you can think of from the time you wake up till the time you sleep, CG Corp Global is part of. But what really sits in the center stage of our group is the work that we do in our foundation. No matter where we go, no matter which company is established anywhere, our prime objective, like we would be focused in implementing the operations of a company, hand in hand, we also look at what is the good we are doing to the society and the community we are operating in. They become a very important stakeholder of our overall presence in a new country. And MoldCell in Moldova has been playing a great role in the past, but especially during the COVID time, we are extremely proud it's been able to really create an impact when needed to the people of Moldova. MoldCell, CG Corp, we all believe in always leading by example. In Nepal, Chowdhury Group and Chowdhury Foundation were the first company in Nepal to sign the UN's SDG goals. Since 2017, being the first private sector company and the foundation, today over a dozen companies have followed suit and have also signed and become part of the SDG program. In Nepal, I must tell you, we are really, really proud of the fact that in these 17 SDGs that exist, the Chowdhury Group and Chowdhury Foundation are doing 43 different initiatives covering all the 17 SDGs. because of our diversified businesses and our diversified foundation role as well. Today in Molcel, I'm extremely happy, extremely delighted that we are embarking on this new journey by signing in an MOU with the UN, as well as with the FPA. It's a matter of great pride for us. And a commitment like this just doesn't come in paper, just it's not from signing. I would like to tell you on behalf of our Molcel team that everyone who's part of the Molcel family are individually, as a team, and as a company, committed in making a difference and following by showing how we can really, really tackle the various SDGs we'll be working towards. Lastly, all I want to say is thank you so much for organizing this event, especially as the first one for a first company in Nepal, in Moldova. It's a very big milestone for us, not only as a company, but I believe that it will also create a new way of thinking to other companies in Moldova as well. All I want to say is that I'm extremely proud of our company, our people in Molcel, our team in Molcel, and this is what differentiates a good company to someone becoming a great company, is when you really realize that you're truly responsible for the various stakeholders, including the environment, the community, the government agencies, and more importantly, the people of Moldova. We are committed to it on behalf of Molcel Foundation. Thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to speak. All I can say is on behalf of our team in Molcel, we are extremely delighted and honored that we partnered with the UN for becoming the first company in Moldova to really own and commit towards the sustainable development goals. Thank you, and I really look forward to reviewing this in the future, adding more SDGs in the future, helping you, UN, to get the word across to all the different companies in Moldova. So wishing you all the best, and thank you once again, and thank you for letting me speak in this prestigious milestone event. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chaudhary, for your inspiring words and your commitment to making the world a better place to live in. With over 20 years of experience on the market, Molcel, one of the biggest mobile telephony companies from Moldova, has always embarked in corporate social responsibility actions and is strongly convinced that doing business should be more accountable and sustainable towards citizens. I would like to give the floor to Mr. Barkan Sechen, CEO of Molcel Company, to deliver his speech. Please.
Well, after very good speeches, I will try to keep it very short. For Molcel, sustainability was always in the center of our business. Sustainability is the main parameter while we are taking our business decisions. The reason is, besides providing communication services to Moldova and citizens of Moldova, for us it's more important to be a role model regarding sustainability and for the future generations to give a better life. So, and as Mr. Nirvan also mentioned, we are all of us very committed to these rules, and not just Molcel employees, our vendors and all ecosystem are also very well trained, contractually binded also for sustainability rules of us set by international standards. And we will continue to work this way because we love it, we enjoy it, and we believe that this is the best thing that we can leave to our next generations and our kids for a better world.
Thank you
for this opportunity one more time.
Thank you for your kind words.
O afacere poate fi considerată responsabilă și sustenabilă doar atunci când există nu doar pentru a face bani, ci și pentru a contribui la dezvoltarea societății din care face parte. Din momentul lansării pe piața comunicațiilor mobile din Republica Moldova, unul dintre scopurile principale ale companiei Molcel a fost și rămâne creșterea și dezvoltarea societății noastre, societății pentru care și în cadrul căreia activăm.
În compania Molcel activează circa 500 de angajați. Angajați care se bucură de cele mai înalte standarde la locul de muncă. Noi încurajăm relații de muncă corecte, etice, bazate pe respect, dezvoltare, pe diversitate, pe inovație, pe profesionalism.
Pe parcursul ultimilor 20 de ani de activitatea sa, compania Molcel a susținut de nenumărate ori dezvoltarea sustenabilă a Republicii Moldova prin diverse proiecte, parteneriate, inovații. Suntem membri și multor asociații de business, precum Asociația Businessului European, Asociația Investitorilor Străini, Camera de Comerț Americană, Asociația Companiilor Private în domeniul TIC, toate având drept scop dezvoltarea și îmbunătățirea calității businessului din Republica Moldova, creării unui mediu transparent pentru principii corecte de afaceri.
Considerăm că adoptarea obiectivelor de dezvoltare durabilă în societatea noastră este foarte importantă, pentru că ne gândim la generațiile viitoare. În cadrul companiei Moldcel, începând din 2014, am implementat programul de etică și conformitate, care are la bază principiile și valorile unei afaceri responsabile. Eforturile depuse în toți acești ani au dus la constituirea unei culturi de transparență și integritate în interiorul companiei, și la definirea unui model de afacere responsabilă în rândul companiilor private din Republica Moldova. Pentru reușitele noastre în dezvoltarea durabilă a activității pe care o desfășurăm, am fost răsplătiți cu trofeul integrității, obținut în acest an în cadrul concursului Marca Comercială a Anului.
Din anul 2014, compania Moldcel este membrul Consiliului de Directori al MILAB, Moldova Innovation Lab, fondat de UNDP, misiunea căruia este să accelereze, să impulsioneze și să promoveze inovații și parteneriate experimentale între guvern, sectorul privat, partenerii externi și UNDP. Ne mândrim că, inspirați de activitatea fundației Chowdhury Foundation, fundație lansată de grupul CG Corp Global, din care face parte compania Moldcel, recent am lansat fundația Moldcel, o platformă care va întruni toate inițiativele sociale și de dezvoltare socială a companiei Moldcel. Am semnat și primul parteneriat privind extinderea oportunităților educaționale în domeniul digital creativ în centrul ArtCorp.
În compania Moldcel promovăm și ne bucurăm de o cultură organizațională axată pe profesionalism și egalitate. Avem 67% femei din totalul de angajați și 33% bărbați. În echipa de management avem 66% femei și 34 bărbați.
Pe parcursul celor 20 de ani de activitate, compania Moldcel s-a implicat foarte activ și a susținut foarte multe proiecte ce țin de educație. Laboratorul tehnic la Universitatea Tehnică din Moldova, computere și acces gratuit la internet pentru familii social vulnerabile din zonele rurale ale țării. Mai recent, Centrul de Excelență Techville, proiectul educațional despre siguranță online, internet fără griji, pentru părinți și copii care au înregistrat mii de participanți în format offline și online. Proiectul Like de la Bunei, misiunea căruia este incluziunea digitală a oamenilor în ietate, în tot ce este lumea digitală. Și sigur că lansarea strategiei de Digitally Responsible, care conține și componenta de Responsible Gaming.
În cadrul companiei Moldcel, începând cu anul 2006, ne-am lansat în parteneriat de succes cu universitățile din Republica Moldova, cu care am implementat proiectul Bursa Moldcel. Scopul acestui proiect a fost și rămâne în continuare susținerea tinerilor studenți, tinerilor viitori specialiști. Astăzi, proiectul Moldcel Academy vine în susținerea studenților ca să-i ajute să îmbine acele studii teoretice cu viața practică profesională din mediul de afaceri.
Уже на протяжении долгих лет стратегией компании является новейшие технологии, акцент на защиту окружающей среды. Начиная с 2015 года, вместо командировок, деловых поездок, мы практикуем телеконференции и видеозвонки. Что касается наших абонентов, кто бы мог подумать, что 8 лет назад именно наш абонент, проживающий в Молдове, сможет подписывать бумаги, декларации, другие финансовые документы, не выходя из дома. Именно мы были одной из 8 стран мира, где мобильная подпись была внедрена. Нашими действиями мы доказали, что диджитализация, приложение – это то, что сегодня клиенту радует глаз. Поэтому мы попытались покрыть все сегменты и внедрить те приложения, которые были бы интересны нашему пользователю.
Компания Moldcel de mai mulți ani la rând s-a implicat în diferite inițiative de susținere și dezvoltare a sistemului medical. Proiectul de mHealth, lansat în 2012, a fost o primă încercare de telemedicină pentru că am oferit un serviciu digital de informare a femeilor însărcinate, precum și a pacienților cu tuberculoză, care au primit și telefoanele mobile cu ajutorul cărora au fost monitorizați de către doctori, au primit și tratament și ne bucurăm că a fost o încercare reușită, care acum constituie o parte componentă a medicinii în general. Nu pot să nu menționez despre proiectul de colaborare între compania Molcel și organizația Salvați Viața și Sfântul Gheorghe. Instituțiile care se ocupă cu colectarea fondurilor pentru pacienții grav bolnavi care au nevoie de intervenții chirurgicale urgente. Și desigur, anul 2020 este momentul în care ne-am mobilizat cu toții în procesul susținerii sistemului medical. 10 ventilatoare pulmonare pentru 8 spitale din Republica Moldova, 5.000 de combinezoane de protecție pentru personalul medical, minute și internet gratuit, precum și prânzuri gratuite zilnice care continuă a fi oferite pentru medicii care sunt eroii noștri.
Avem o echipă minunată de voluntari de rândul angajaților Molcel, numită Purple Team, care deja de 8 ani se implică în activități și proiecte sociale pentru a face lumea mai bună. Astfel, vizităm și ajutăm bătrânii, aducem zâmbete pe fețele copiilor din orfelinate, oferim donații și suport pentru familiile social vulnerabile. Purple Team este dornic să răspândească fapte bune și să învețe noua generație prin propriul exemplu de a se implica personal și proactiv în comunitatea noastră. Cu pași mici, dar constanți, să eradicăm sărăcia în toate formele sale.
Pe parcursul ultimilor 7 ani, Molcel se menține în top 10 cei mai buni angajatori ai anului. Oferă șanse egale pentru toți, indiferent de vârstă, etnie și limbă vorbită. În acest context, mă bucur să avem încadrați în echipa noastră și persoane cu dizabilități, pentru care am creat locurile de muncă specializate și acces în toate blocurile noastre de muncă.
Digitalizarea și tehnologiile moderne oferă posibilități nelimitate absolut pentru toți. Acesta a fost motivul și mesajul companiei Molcel, care câțiva ani în urmă a susținut primul proiect social de modă pentru femei cu dizabilități locomotorii și boli incurabile, Dare Fashion Social Show. După a urmat al doilea proiect din domeniul DARE, o școală de afaceri pentru femei cu dizabilități locomotorii. Încă un proiect de reducere a inegalităților a avut loc 5 ani în urmă și continuă până acum, maratonul mobil de la Molcel, cu ajutorul căruia am cutrierat împreună cu echipa de voluntari prin toată țara pentru ca să arătăm oamenilor în ietate ce sunt telefoane mobile, ce este internet și ce avantaje există în lumea digitală care pot să le ușureze viața și să le facă viața mai interesantă la orice vârstă.
În 2008, Molcel a fost printre fondatorii rețelei Pactului Global a Națiunilor Unite în Republica Moldova, prezidându-l. Iar astăzi suntem prima companie privată care semnă memorandumul împreună cu Organizația Națiunilor Unite, reprezentanța în Moldova, pentru susținerea obiectivelor dezvoltării durabile în Republica Moldova. Este convingerea noastră, a angajaților companiei Molcel, cât și acționarilor noștri CG Corp Global, că doar împreună vom putea obține o societate mult mai bună, cât pentru noi, atât și pentru viitoarele generații.
Today's the 11th, right?
Yes, Mr. Chen will bring another copy, the same.
This one also needs?
Yes, and two copies, one from the company and one from the
Mr. This also needs to be signed.
population and enhance the intergenerational dialogue, especially in the context of the pandemic. Before I give the floor to Ms. Negina Abazadze, resident representative of UNACRI in Moldova, to speak about the core of this cooperation, I would like to say a few words about UNACRI, which is the lead agency of the United Nations for reproductive health and rights. UNACRI supports the country to build resilience towards demographic challenges by empowering young people, promoting healthy aging, supporting women and men to realize their desired fertility, and creating a conducive environment for all women and men to enjoy equal rights. The floor is yours, Ms. Negina.
Thank you very much, Christina and colleagues. Dear Mr. Bakansijan and dear Irina Strajescu, Simon, and all other colleagues from Moldcel family, it is my great pleasure that UNFPA, United Nations Population Fund, is joining partnership with Moldcel today. As one of the members of the UN family, UNFPA is working hard to realize sustainable development goals and supporting Moldovan government to achieve SDGs related to health and well-being, social inclusion, and protection of rights and dignity for all at all ages. Successful sustainable development requires dynamic and inclusive strategic partnerships that involve full diversity of stakeholders. Business sector, including national and multinational corporations, middle and small enterprises, corporate foundations, are key stakeholders to public and private partnerships. Private companies have knowledge, resources, and innovative power that can help us reaching the most vulnerable persons and truly leaving no one behind in sustainable development. In that regard, I would like to thank Moldcel for its innovative vision and being a champion for social change, and we all witness how many projects you are actually already implementing. We as UNFPA are very delighted to welcome Moldcel to UNFPA program on intergenerational solidarity between young and older persons. This partnership will foster greater social inclusion of older persons and boost social cohesion through enhancing digital skills of older persons by engaging young people. I have to say that one-fourth of Moldovan's population is over 60, and this population group has been highly affected by COVID-19 pandemic and isolation period. I'm sure that each of us witnessed this through our own parents and all the persons of our families. So, and while all of us are moved to the digital world, to the digital reality, not only for business operation, but also for the social support, all the persons couldn't do that. They experienced significant barriers in accessing online technologies and digital resources. They cannot benefit from virtual digital social support networks. They cannot benefit from free interaction with family and community members who are far from them. And they cannot benefit full access to social services. In Moldova, only 3% of all the persons are using digital devices. Compare this with over about 40% of all the persons in EU countries. So it's clear that we have to invest more and more in narrowing this digital gap. We also have to know that more and more older persons stay alone due to out-migration. Therefore, creative alternative communication activities, including digital literacy, is absolutely necessary. However, the innovative approach that we offer as UNFPA is applied through the specific through boosting intergenerational dialogue between young people and older persons. Young people are used as community mobilizers. Young people are engaged in interaction with the older persons. And this will lead to not only narrowing digital divide, but also improving the emotional well-being of older persons, social inclusion, and facilitate sharing knowledge and experiences between these two generations, young and older persons. So UNFPA experience at national and global levels shows that this approach has proven to be very impactful on people's life, both young and older persons. And in a country like Moldova, that is facing rapid population aging and where young people play important role in sustainable development, building partnership between generations is essential. In long term, this will lead to social solidarity and successful human development. So once again, thank you very much, dear colleagues, dear MOLTSA colleagues, for your openness, for partnership and innovative vision in that sense. We highly value this partnership. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Positively impact the lives of Moldovans by combining digital transformation and use of technologies based on its digital responsibility, key areas, education, society, social impact investments, UN Sustainable Development Goals support. Irina Strajevsku is the Executive Director of MOLTSA Foundation, and I would like to invite her to give us an insight on the foundation's activity and the joint project with UNFPA. And immediately after this, we shall proceed to the signing of the cooperation agreement between UNFPA and MOLTSA Foundation.
Thank you so much, Christina. Dear partners, friends, colleagues, it feels great to be here today, and it feels absolutely great when ideas of beautiful projects coincide. It means that they are really worth implementing, and like this today, we are entering into a partnership that is meant to make the society of Moldova a better place to live. You know, 5 years ago, in 2015, internet was already an indispensable part of our lives. And we at MOLTSEL, because we are the ones who offer internet and offer digital services and smartphones, actually decided that we take the responsibility for the fact that absolutely all categories of the population in Moldova use internet. As we found out that elderly population, our grandparents and parents, in our case, don't use internet, don't know how to use it, don't use smartphones, and even have a certain fear towards everything that is digital. And you know, together with MOLTSEL team of volunteers, purple team that you have seen in the video, we got united and we went to rural areas and we had dozens of seminars training elderly population of Moldova about what internet is and how it can help them in their daily lives. And then, of course, the project has evolved and MOLTSEL was offering very affordable devices and very affordable tariff plans that could be used by elderly population as well. The project has evolved into something beautiful that we call now Like de la Bune, and I will show you here is the guide of the project. We thought the thinking behind this project was that of course, we can change things by means of MOLTSEL team of volunteers, purple team, but it will be a tiny particle of the change that can be done. So we thought, why not encourage all the teenagers from Moldova, teach their grandparents digital technologies, how to use smartphones, how to use social media, how to use internet, because this is the way how it happens. For example, in my family, my mother has a tab, she always has problems with it, and she always doesn't address me, but my children, who are eager to help her. And this, as Ms. Nigina said, will contribute, first of all, to the communication between these two generations, and will eliminate the generation gap, and will contribute to the digitalization of the elderly population. So it's funny, we wanted to launch, have a physical launch event in March 2020 of this project, but then COVID happened and we canceled the event. So we have refocused fully to online. We published these guides on MOLTSEL MD. They can be found. They are written in both in Romanian and Russian in very simple language. We also try to train the teenagers how to approach elderly, how to be patient, tolerant, give them more time to understand you know, the matters, difficult matters for them. And during summer, when kids were not busy with school. We encourage them on Instagram to really teach their grannies on how to use internet and how to use smartphones so that they could stay connected, especially during this lockdown period, especially during pandemics. And we have a video prepared about this project, a short one. Before we put it, we are very happy to sign the partnership today with UNFPA and help those elderly population that don't have teenagers, their grandchildren living together with them, who are lonely and who are from rural areas. So it is, we are very thankful to you that you initiated this project, and we are here to help you.
Мой телефон для меня – это все.
Вырубеску приятельный, фамилия.
Пара коммуникария наш петя, замфак релатику приятельный.
Я сижу очень много в соцсетях.
Шап, ты сидишь прочень, ты день темпу петракот.
Нон-стоп. Только когда я сплю, я не сижу в нем.
Коммуникария. Pentru mine înseamnă foarte mult, fiindcă mi-e îmi place să comunic.
Când eram de seama lui Valeria, nici televizoare nu erau atunci. Nu era lumină, nu era telefoane nici fixe.
Numai prin scrisori comunicam.
Bunica este o persoană care nu prea ține cu rețelele sociale.
Eu numai pe fix, că când fixă mai ușor, dar cu mobil mai... Mai greu un pic.
Mă întreabă ce faceți voi toată ziua pe internet, adică mă întreabă ce e interesant acolo, pentru ea nu este clar?
Practic n-am văzut bătrâni care să stea pe Facebook și mai ales bunica, ea nu prea știe cum să folosească.
Mama vorbește cu bunica și deja, dacă sunt alături, vorbesc și eu.
Nu prea des, dar cel puțin o dată pe lună discutăm.
Poate fi o dată pe săptămână, adică da, este puțin drastic. Штрист.
По субботам там звоним друг другу по телефону, так, что сегодня на ужин, приходите на ужин.
Кто-то, когда ей винла меня по интернету, вот, по исландцам, вот, да, да, аша, я сингур сам интернет, я на.
Бунеи не ау диспозитивы мобили. Din cauza că nu se poate folosi.
Mi-e legce napisati. Dacă le zvoniu, tot ca delu, tak, nenadolgă.
Dacă ar putea să utilizeze aceste metode de comunicare, ar dezvolta și această comunicare între generația tânără și generația mai în vârstă.
Tehnica e deoperiod, atât noi уже, как бы, привикли к тем телефонам, но так стараемся.
Требуем еще мы с ними живем по скуей, так время с ней интеллига, что мы с ней интеллигим по ей.
Так арфея Facebook, а мы хотя с коммуникаем больше, поте, я рвдя, че фак я у на школу, сау, че фак на активности с ними лизиниче, что ж хотя с я у собой дома идез.
Макар на батарнеце так, нам а вот по накума.
Новое поколение, они вообще дети эти рождены уже космические, скажем так, дети. Мы люди тех лет. Конечно, нам немножко сложнее, но интерес есть, желание есть научиться, знать.
Общение – это всегда хорошо.
Коммуникация сам фарти мод.
Ой, очень важно, очень дорого. Почему? Потому что они не живут рядом со мной, они живут в другой стране.
Почаще бабушки были рядом с внуками. Вот это самое главное.
Ну, я encourageam să învețe, să discute, să nu se piardă.
Катерина Путика Александрина m-a învățat, a zis că bunica trebuie să ai și Instagram.
Они мне для общения, говорит, бабушка, мы тебе купим планшет. Почаще общаться, почаще в ихнюю жизнь заглядывать. Иногда маме не расскажешь, приходишь до бабушки, расскажу. У нас много, часто было.
Foundation for this video, and indeed the pandemic has hit hard on the elder generation, and this project is very much needed and I think very useful. So now, ladies, I would like to invite you to sign the cooperation agreement that is on the table in front of you.
Thank you. And with this, our event comes to an end. And I would like to thank you, everyone who has joined our event online, and our guests present here for the time and participation. Have a nice day and goodbye to everyone who is joining us or has joined us, online.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
In normal life, we would shake hands now.
Yes, let's at least have a selfie. Huh?
Exactly, yeah. I mean, we should...
Without masks, yeah. Maybe.
Somehow connect a little bit.
Tanya, jump upon your background picture.